Alright, I hope you can see this, even though it is a little bright in here. What this is a stuff called Catasil. It's basically fiberglass resin and very fine pieces of, or micro bubbles of plastic. Okay? It's very similar to stuff called door glass or Bondo glass. Only he doesn't have the finely chopped strands of fiberglass in it. It's very lightweight. That's why I like to use it. Okay? What I'm doing here is we're actually going to build up a molding around the window. The reason we're going to build up a molding around the window is this is where we're going to put, well, this is what we're going to glue the glass in. As you can see, I haven't done all of it. I'm doing a little bit at a time. I'm working it in there. I'm making sure that it hardens up the properly and stuff like that. And I'm not getting any on the outside. So I'm actually, you know, taking my time, doing it right, and getting it done, you know, in a timely manner. Meanwhile, my assistant out here, as you can see, is mixing up the fiberglass, and we use what's called red MEK here. That's what he's mixing up. The red MEK gives it a unique color. Okay. It also there's also a clear MEK which we don't use for this type of installation, but this is how we can tell what the consistency is. We're looking for basically a dark red mixture so that it cures fast but doesn't overheat the body. Thank you. Alright, now, as you can see, I'm actually moving, you know, get more put up. Okay. And as each time we do this, we add to it and we put more and more up until we've done all the way around. Now, this is one way of doing it. Okay? But this is not the only way. I've had people tell me that they use a method that's called the halo. Basically, they take a piece of wood, they cut it to the sides of the window. Then they mark the opening of the window onto it, and then they cut the window, the center of the plywood out. They use wood. And then they trim it so that it fits over the window. And then they bond it into place with Bondo. Okay? It sounds to me to be a very simple way of doing it. I'm actually considering trying it, although not on this car. I'll be happy to do it on a different car, but this one's going to get everything done the same way because that's the way I am. So I have another car I'm going to try to do it on. I'm going to make a pattern. I'm going to glue the halo into place the way I've been told to do it. And we'll see how that works. So let's first finish this car. Now, I tend to overfill this area. The reason is I can always knock it down so that it's flush with the window. And that gives me a much better seat or place to glue the window to. Each time we do this, it expends, I think each one of these would probably take about a half a gallon of Bondo to do. Alright? Thank you. Alright, as you can see, I'm almost done with this. I'm going to do a little bit more smoothing out here. I'm going to build it up just a hair more. Now, before I say this is about a half a gallon of Bondo. Let me tell you what a half a gallon of Bondo is. So put it up. Anyway. Right there. Okay? Very good. Okay? This is about a half a gallon of Bondo. What is a half a gallon of Bondo? Well, if you've ever done any body work, a half a gallon of Bondo is what generally is on your floor after you've done a fender. Okay? After you smoothed out a fender and ground it and done several passes with the sander, a half a gallon of Bondo is what you find on the floor after you're done. Okay? We all tend to put a lot of Bondo on there, onto our cars, and break it down to where everything is. Look, now, I'm not going to grind all this up.
No.
This is going to be smoothed out just slightly, and then we're going to bond to it. We're going to bond to it with the window well primer and the tape and all that. So this is really not that big a deal. We're not going to get rid of it. It's just going to stay with the car. It's very lightweight, and it's going to do nicely over the years, holding this window into place. While my assistant tapes the back window, I'm going to show you what it looks like from the outside. Okay, fairly simple. I get no spillage all over the edge. The tape is only there to protect the body surface around the edge. And here he goes. He's going to show you what he's doing. He's doing the same thing for the back window. He's about to start on it. He's going to be doing the back window so he can learn how to do it. And right now he's taping it up so he can put the cabosil into place. Very simple process.